Hey guys, so I've been listening to your comments, to your messages. I realize a lot of you don't like the Lego stuff. You don't like the Lego Lord of the Rings. You don't like the Lego Monster Fighters. So I thought, hey, to make some of you happy, perhaps I'll do my first Star Wars review. The first thing that I'm ever doing that is Star Wars related. And that is the Star Wars X-Wing Fighter made by Lego. I've wanted one of these for a very, very long time. Even before I was getting back into the whole toy game. I saw, like, an X-Wing, I'm not sure if it was this exact same set, and they've just been repackaging over the years, and a Millennium Falcon, and I wanted them so very much. So it's something very, very fun for me to finally have one in my possession. You can see, this is the X-Wing. This is set number 9493, if you care about that kind of thing. 560 pieces. This is the biggest thing that I'm going to attempt to build on my little table here. Not sure it's going to work very well. I may have to relocate to a bigger location, but we'll see how that works out. Now, the minifigures in this set, you, of course, get a... You get a Luke Skywalker, you get an R2-D2, you get an R5-D8, but the main reason you are buying this set, ladies and gentlemen, you get a Porkins. Can you hear that? Can you hear that? That sound, that relief, that excitement that everyone is feeling right now? You can finally have a Lego Jack Porkins. Such a good feeling. Of course, in X-Wing fashion, the wings can contract and open if you do, if you're surprised. I don't know why you should be. Go in the back real quick, and there's some random stuff. A pilot fits inside. A droid fits there. The cockpit opens up to show the pilot inside. The pilots can interact. The pilots and droids can interact. It's stuff that you really should be expecting. Oh, and of course, a big feature, a landing gear. So let's open this thing up. And just like magic, we have Lego pieces! A lot of Lego pieces! Yay! So we have bag 4, 5, 1, 2, and 3. This is different. I don't have any of these in my previous sets. When Charlie Sheen had a kid. So here we have the booklets. This is going to be something interesting, I can already tell. It does appear to be broken up between books and the bags, so... That'll be fun. Oh, boy. Oh, look at how complex that interior is going to be. Oh, this is going to be fun. I'm going to be here for hours. This is going to be a really long video. So, okay. Bag 1 makes the full interior mechanisms. Bag 2 starts making the nose cone section and the cockpit's finished. And then bag 3 will make the two wings. Bag 4 makes the other two wings. Or... something, and then bag 5 does all the fancy details at the end, so that shouldn't be too terrible. So I guess I'll get rid of bag 4, 5. We do have some stickers are always fun, and I'll get rid of bag 3. So I'm just left with bag 1 and 2, and I guess all that's left to do now is get building.
It's almost 5 a.m. I'm feeling kind of stuffed up and I don't know how this sounds. My cat is staring at me. I don't know what to do. He looks quite sleepy and a little concerned. He probably thinks that I'm losing my mind now. He might have a point. I'm doing weird stuff. I don't know really. What I'm going to say, I wish I could finish building this ship now. I have like to do right now. Like go to sleep. Like I said, it's 5 a.m. I'm feeling kind of sleepy and it's raining now. It's quite relaxing. I should go to bed. But I am dedicated to finish this video. I can't keep rhythm, I'm sorry to say. I don't really know running out on 7th Jupiter. Did you know Jupiter's a planet? And I like Jupiter. 7 of 9 was in Star Trek. He's not in Star Wars. Did you know J.J. Abrams is doing the next Star Wars? That's going to be really neat. I don't know what's going to happen. And they're going to have Luke, and they're going to have Han. And then you can tell I've run out of things to say, so I'm just going to ramble on and on. And I sit here, and I'm questioning my stance in life, and wonder if I should change what I'm doing. Oh, look, the X-Men's almost done here. Okay, and look. I think I'm done. Woo!
And here's the whole thing built. I think my time is about an hour and a half, just throwing in times to fix these stickers. I had to redo each of them a few times. I wanted them to get as even as possible. Applying stickers, I had to find a missing rubber band that popped off at some point. That was fun. And just kind of going back and fixing that I missed here and there. A few pieces that I put on wrong. When you are getting this set, just keep in mind, oh, I just knocked out the most important character ever, that it's going to be light gray, and then dark gray, and then the orange. I had it light gray because I thought it blended in. Apparently, it's meant to be dark gray, just so you know. But here we have the X-Wing, and this thing is so very cool. I could be biased because I've wanted this for so long, so maybe I'm just kind of enamored by how nice it looks, but having this in hand, this is a very, very fun build. This one is going to tie along with what I said about the Mad Scientist set from the Monster Fighters line. It's everything I was hoping for and more. This is the perfect definition of that. This is a very, very fun set. You see all the details in the back. It does have the thrusters. The wings can, of course, open. The S-foils, I should probably say, for those Star Wars purists out there. You turn the little crank here, and then we have locked into their attack position. You cannot have an X-Wing without having it in the attack position. That's just the rule. The rule of everything. It was really, really neat to get this all done. The landing gear does fold up. Just take that and it tucks away in there. This was very, very intricate because, as I mentioned, bag one is just the interior. Everything fits together. All the rods that help turn the wings, everything. Bag two was primarily the nose cone all the way up to here. And then, I think, continuing on with the windshield and such. Bag 3 and 4 were the wings, and then bag 5 was, like, the guns, and then the thrusters, that kind of stuff. This was a really, really exciting thing to put together, to kind of see how things built up. And, I do like it. I do have a couple of minor complaints. While it does feel very solid in hand, there are some pieces that are just held in slightly. And I've noticed in the back, if you do the wings enough times, keep an eye on this section there. Maybe you'll see it, maybe not. So let's see. I know I said that, but you can't even see the gap. But the more you do it, the more this kind of breaks apart. This whole section, you can see all through there, it's kind of breaking apart. That's normal. That's just from the two wings being together. So you do have to kind of have some care with it. You don't want to be too forced. You don't want to do this too many times. Otherwise, the wings will come apart. But that's not really a big deal. It's Lego. It's meant to be played with, and then occasionally you have to put a new piece back onto it. If anything does pop off, it pops back on very easily. And I'm just really impressed with how the wings work. I was curious how they would do it. But you can see it's very, very simple. It's just this little piece inside just holds it up, just like that. It's so simple when you see it this way, but whoever came up with this whole design, my hat's off to you. This is a very, very cool set, and I enjoy it immensely. There are some stickers to put on. You have some here for, I'm guessing, the intakes, and you have these back here. There's one sticker for this piece here, and there's one for this little 1x1 brick, and that goes for all the wings as well. If you look on the inside, there's just some little minor detail to kind of make it so it's not just plain old bricks, but when you open the cockpit, you'll see it actually does have, if I can actually get it without dropping it. Oh, I dropped it again. Get out of there. Oh, no. That's not where you're supposed to go. There we go. It actually has a little targeting system. This is the kind of thing that Lego does that always impresses me. It's a minor detail. You wouldn't even notice it being gone. But the fact that they included it is, if I can actually focus on it, makes it all the better. You see it's actually flying into the Death Star. So that's a really nice detail to include. And I am extremely happy with this set. Let me get that back on before I do drop it. I'm going to drop it again, because that's what I do. Now, as for the minifigures of the set, you do get four. You have an R2 unit, R2-D2, if you will, which is very, very cute, very adorable. I like it a lot, of course. The little legs do move. Although, I don't know, you can kind of position it in multiple ways. You can have it like that, you can have it like that, whichever you so desire. We do have a Luke Skywalker. Now, this is kind of neat. I had a Star Wars set from, I want to say, maybe the Phantom Menace. Maybe. An old set. And the lightsaber with it was, the hilt was chromed. And that paint, that chrome detail would flake off very, very easily. I'm really glad to see they're using this kind of metallic plastic now instead of the chrome. It's going to last a lot longer. And I like it a lot. It's really neat just having a lightsaber again. I probably have my other one somewhere if I can just find it. Next, we of course have, I think it's R5-D8. Yeah, it's R5-D8. And it's basically the same body as R2-D2, just with a lot more red. That's the only major difference. Some white is filled with red. Some blue is replaced with red. It's a neat thing, and of course the dome top is different. But same basic idea. And of course, the reason you are buying this set is for the one and only Porkins. Sweet, adorable, brave Porkins, who comes with a rifle. A nice detail is that him and Luke both have different helmets, which is how it should be. It's a nice detail that they actually included, having two different helmets. Their actual jumpsuits are the same. I would have liked if Porkins could have had some more curves for his belly. Just saying. But you can take your fighter pilot. And their helmets, of course, do come off. Stick them right inside the cockpit, just like that. And then you can take your droid. Now, I always assumed the droids went in this way, but maybe I've been wrong all these years, and they go in this way. But you're going to take it, rotate the head around so they're looking forward, and then just kind of get them inside, and they peg right in. Easy peasy. And there you go, ready to go fight off the Galactic Empire. However, this is not the end of the set. Porkins is a very special character, and as such, he deserves a lot more. So he comes with a lot more. Porkins here is the main hero of the Rebel Alliance. That is true. Everyone knows that. So of course, he gets hungry. He needs to be rewarded. That's why Porkins comes with his own pizza delivery truck. You can have this guy right here. A nice detail they've included is this horrified face. So when Porkins is unhappy about how long it's taking for his pizza to arrive, he hops in the X-Wing, chases down the pizza guy, and you can see he is quite fearful for his life when it comes to that point. Honestly, I would be too. But when you order pizza, you want it to be fresh and hot, blazing fast delivery. When it's not blazing fast, you gotta get angry. Now, the delivery truck also comes with two little pizzas that you can give Mr. Porkins there. He also comes with two more pizza boxes, another two pizza boxes, even more pizza boxes, and because he got bored waiting, he has two regular pizzas. He's got his money to pay, and he's got a coupon for Pizza Hut delivery. So Porkins better get a discount. And you can, of course, have him holding his coupon, holding his money. Have him there, just waiting for the pizza guy. And the pizza guy just shows up all brrrr, and then just runs away screaming. But that's not enough. That's not enough for our dear Porkins. Being that he is a hero, that he's being honored for all of his years of service to the Rebellion, he comes with two turkeys. And you can, of course, take this out. You can take the turkey leg, stick it in his hand, get him ready to go. And I don't seem to have it on me at the moment. Because, oh wait, I do have it. He also comes with, because you gotta have some variety when you're flying through space, he comes with a large sausage. So, You can have Porkins ready to go take on the Empire. Open up this little cockpit here, stick him inside, ready to go. And he's all set. He's ready to go. You can even give him some pizzas. Give him some pizza boxes inside there to keep him extra happy. We're going to put those in there. We can put one behind him. And then we could probably even close this up still, I think. Oh, maybe not. There may be too much going on at once. I don't know. It's going to be a really tight fit. You can see Porkins really shouldn't be keeping all this food with him when he's flying. But, you know, he's a regular guy. He likes food. Nothing wrong with that. There we go. Ready to go. And you know what? Just for added effect, let's give him one more. Just because. He deserves it. Porkins has earned it. And then you can, of course, take your pizzas, scatter them across the X-Wing as if it's, you know, just coming home from a party. He does like to party hard. He took the words of Andrew W.K. to heart. And we can just kind of, you know, deck out the X-Wing in pizza boxes. Because why not? Why not, I say? And there you go. There is your Porkins set. There is also an attachment to turn your R5 unit to give him a serving tray. I don't have this one. It is an exclusive to the Zimbabwe Lego store, and they were sadly sold out. But you can give a serving tray to your R5 unit, which will allow it to hold this this frying pan for Porkins. So, as you can tell, all the stuff you get with Porkins is absolutely worth it. It makes the set a lot more enjoyable. You have a lot more playability with. You can have the X-Wing just going to town, chasing down this little pizza truck, and just making this guy's life a living hell. Yeah, you can do all kinds of things with it. So if you do want to get this set, you can get it for about $60 at certain retail locations. EntertainmentEarth.com has it as well. I would say pick it up from them. They have really good service. I like shopping with them. And you can add this to your collection. If you cannot tell, I enjoy it. I enjoy it a lot. And I'm not going to actually include Luke and R2 in the X-Wing. The X-Wing is strictly for Porkins. Luke and R2 are going to go on their own little adventure with their own little friends. So they can just stay there. But that's all that I can say for this set. Pick it up if you are a Star Wars fan. It is very, very worth it. And it just looks amazing on display. Oh, and you can see what I mean. This whole thing has started to come apart. So you have to be kind of careful with this, with how often you do it. You have to check it occasionally to make sure everything is being held in place. There's not really much support back here with these little bricks, just the way they are. So just kind of watch out for that. But still, you will have no problems with it. It's very enjoyable. And I adore it. So that's all that I can say, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you have a great day. Thanks for watching, as always. I will see you around. Take care.